For strait is the gate, and narrow the way that leads to life, and few there be that find it. As we travel down the road of life with our great teacher, preacher, physician, we watch him cope with his temptations, listening to him on the mountain as he tears down traditions and replaces them with more meaningful doctrines. We see him as he heals the sick and forgives those who acknowledge that they are burdened with sin. We become increasingly aware, though, of one thing, that there are no shortcuts. There are no detours on this road that leads to Calvary, neither for Jesus nor for us. For Jesus, it was always a journey of giving, giving even unto the most supreme sacrifice of his own life. To us, it is a journey of learning. With each lesson that he teaches, we become better equipped to meet and handle the anxieties and trials of living, many of which, sadly enough, are self-imposed. Like him, when we complete this journey and experience the full meaning of it, there is a feeling of satisfaction and well-being like nothing else in this world. Because while Jesus was first the Son of God, he was also indeed the Son of Man, in that he experienced emotions much like our own. He knew he had fulfilled his mission on earth, he had put in a job well done, and that his sacrifice would never be in vain. For us, not only do we find answers to our immediate problems, far more, for us we will receive a gift that all the wealth of 10,000 worlds like the one in which we live could not buy. For any who would walk through Calvary with Jesus, the wages of sin are settled when we pass from this world. This is something that has been fixed and cannot be changed. But there's something else that is fixed and cannot be changed, and that is the promise of eternal life through the Son of God. These are the facts revealed to us by the inspired writer not too long before he gave his own life for declaring these truths which our teacher first spoke. There's somewhat of a sad note in the statement, "Few there are that find it." Not that this way is hard to find, but the tragedy is that so few actually look for it. We get so caught up in our ambitions, our desires for the pleasures of this world, that we forget our priorities until hopefully we wake up to the fact that there is a better way, a pathway in life that circumvents the mad rush down this broad way that leads to nothing but a dead end, that leads to destruction. Friends, this is the broad way, and its road signs are out there. They're manifest to us. And we see these signs in attitudes, things such as short tempers, distrust, a haughty spirit. And they're easy to read. And they tell us very clearly if we're on this wrong road or not. We all recognize the fact that there are times when circumstances are beyond our control. Things such as sickness, losing a job. We see these unfortunate situations every day. And too often our first instinct is to try to place the blame somewhere else. Well, this, of course, is not the answer and only serves to compound the circumstances. The reason we find ourselves in these and similar circumstances goes back many years to the Garden of Eden, when the serpent came in, tempted Adam and Eve, and sin entered into this world. But friends, mankind has invented many ways to meet the challenge of this destroyer. We have things such as image worship, building fabulous edifices to worship in, and even concocting our own doctrines and philosophies. But all of these things that we try are to no avail. All of these things that are a part of man-made religion are keeping people on that broad way that leads to destruction. So what is the answer? The answer is found at this place called Calvary, where we meet this great and wonderful teacher who walks with us on this narrow way which leads to that straight gate that opens to an eternity of peace and contentment that is beyond our comprehension. We simply have to be willing to look for it. Friends, we thank you for joining us for our program today, and have a blessed day.